Hello and welcome to 12th Commerce students. Today in this class, I will discuss about the different elements of communication as I have told you earlier. Now, the elements in the process of communication starts with sender. I have told you that the process starts with sender. This is the first element in the process of communication. The sender is the person who initiates the process of communication. He may be a superior, a subordinate, a fellow member, a customer, or any outside person, but the process starts with sender. After sender comes encoding. Encoding. This refers to preparing the subject matter of the communication in the suitable language. The purpose of encoding is to translate the thought of the sender into a language or code the message. Code that can be easily understandable to the receiver of the message. So it tends to translate the message. Next is the message. Next element is the message. Message refers to the encoded subject matter of the communication which is to be transmitted. The message may be regarded as the subject matter. So you can call this message as subject matter. Next is medium. Medium means through which the message is to be transmitted. It is the channel. This is the path in which the message is transmitted from one person to the other. It served as a link between the sender and the receiver. So you can call this medium as a channel or link which is chosen for transferring the message. Next element is decoding. Now decoding refers to the conversion of message by the receiver into the meaningful terms. So in order to make the communication understandable, the effectiveness of a communication depends how much the receiver's decoding matches with the sender's message. So it helps to transfer or convert and make it understandable. Now the effectiveness of communication depends on this decoding. Now next comes after decoding. Comes the receiver. The receiver is a person who receives the message of the sender for communication to be effective. It must be receiver oriented. So he is the communicatee. You can call the receiver as the communicatee. Next, finally comes the feedback. Feedback refers to the actual response of the receiver to the message. So, the communication, communicating to him. It is a reversal of the communication process in which the receiver expresses his reactions to the sender of the message. So, after a receiver, the last element in this process is feedback, which means the response. After receiving the message, there is a response which is always coming from the receiver side, and that response is called the feedback. So feedback is the last element in the whole process of communication. So you can see that the chain is starting. The process of communication is a longer process. It is starting from the sender. So sender is the first element, and in the way lies these things like encoding, message, that is the subject matter, the medium, the channel, the link, the decoding, finally the receiver, and last comes the feedback. After the process of communication ends with feedback, when the receiver gives any feedback, when the receiver gives any response, any reaction of having the message, and that reaction is sent to the sender back, at that it this chain ends, this communication, the whole chain of communication ends. So this is the process of communication. This is how communication takes place in an organization, formally or informally. Now I will tell you about the characteristics of these communication. Communication has got various characteristics. Now I will explain to you the characteristics one by one. Now comes the characteristics of communication. Communication is a cooperative process. It needs cooperation. Cooperation from both sender and the receiver. The two person must be cooperating with each other. So it is a cooperative process. It is a process involving the participation of both the person who transmit the message and the one who receives the message. So it is a cooperative process. This is the first salient feature of communication. Secondly comes the continuous. It is a continuous process. It is required by the superior and subordinate and fellow members on a continuous basis to keep the operations running smoothly. There must be a continuous flow of communication from the top level to the down level, from the authority to the subordinate, so that the work should be flown uninterruptedly. So continuous communication must be there. So it is called a continuous process. Like planning and all other process, it is called continuous process. Thirdly, it is a two-way process. Two-way process means it involves sending the message and receiving the message and response to the message. So it is not completed unless and until the receiver has understood the message. And understanding is the end. Understanding and giving response or reaction to the communication is the last stage. So understanding this completes, this process, whole process completes. So it can be not only transmission, receiving the message also is there. So it is called a two-way process. Achha. Other than this, there is another feature of that is flow of information must be there. The purpose of communication is flow of expressions, flow of opinion, flow of ideas. So flow of all these messages is required. So the purpose of communication is to pass on information in order to keep it running, keep everything uninterrupted, in order to bring about a commonness of interest and effort. So flow of information. Finally comes, it is a pervasive function. Why pervasive? Because it is applicable in all types of department, in all types of management, top, middle, lower, and manufacturing, financial, personal department, in all the departments, communication must be there. So it is pervasive in nature. Pervasive means what? It is applicable in all types of organization and in all types of department also. So it is a circular process, because I have told you the process of communication starts with the sender and receiving a feedback by the sender. So it goes on in a circular movement. It is a circular process. It flows in all direction. It influences human behavior. It is the main purpose is conveying a message, which is given. Conveying a message is similar to flow of information. So these are the quite common features which you can include in your answer when you will be asked to give the characteristics of communication. So that's all for today. Wait for my next video.